lovers, thank you for tuning in. You know what time it is, it's record fair time. And not even any record fair, but the biggest record fair in the world, located in Utrecht in the Netherlands. I'm really excited, but just to show you how overwhelming this record fair is, there are 500 plus sellers there, so let's do a quick math. If I assume I would admit around 100 sellers because they don't cater my taste, and I would spend roughly 5 minutes on every stall just browsing through, which is unrealistic, then it would take me roughly 33 hours to get through everything. I only have 6. Even though I'm bad at math, I know it's just impossible. And it's overwhelming and terrifying. Excited at the same time, because it's always fun to see all the sellers from around the world, and of course we all hope to find some grades. So I just thought it would be fun to take you with me and to show you what the fair's like. So let the madness begin.
Let the madness begin, nigga. Let it begin, let the madness begin, and let the brain blow with your grin. Let it begin, let it begin. We'll be right back.
Impressions. Yeah, as you could see, it was again overwhelming, and of course there were again sellers with totally extreme prices. I think my highlight was a Russian seller who had admittedly really great stuff like Panel Regalis, and my husband just picked up the Gandalf record, and there were no prices on it, and he was asking him like, how much do you want for that, and he was like, $1,000. And my husband was like, seriously? Good luck with that. I mean, yeah, it's quite a pricey record, but not that pricey. So, yeah. I was even so perplexed that I didn't film it. It was great being there, seeing a lot of sellers from all over the globe, like South Korea and Tunisia and Brazil. And I visited a lot of great stores, but I just wished I had more time. And one of my highlights was meeting Paul, XJunkieNL, which you might know, I hope you know him. I will link his channel below so you can check him out. He has just the greatest funk and soul taste ever. It was interesting being there on a Sunday in comparison to the Saturdays before, because the advantage on a Sunday is that the sellers are packing and you have a lot of stores where people are like, okay, it's 25% off for everything, but the disadvantage is also people are packing, so that means around 3 p.m. people are just packing, and you even get more pressure because you need to hurry even more. Yeah, this was my recap. I just want to quickly show you what we got. Jorge Ben Atabua de Esmeralda. I found this at the stand from Human Head New York, which was pretty great to see. And this is the 1985 Brazilian repress. I was really happy to find this because I only have a dodgy counterfeit reissue of that, which sounds totally off. So I'm really happy to finally have this and be able to play this. Dave D. Dozibiki, Mick and Titch.
Dave D. Dozibiki, Mitch and Titch.
Who?
Dave D. Dozibiki, Mitch and Titch.
I mainly got this because of the great Hold Tight song, which might be familiar if you are a fan of Quentin Tarantino stuff. But the rest is good pop fun too. Don Robertson, Don, released on Limelight. I had this on my wantlist ever since Matt Sands showed it. This is a crazy mixture between kind of spa music and psychedelic stuff, but yeah, it's just a great listen. Muddy Waters, At the Rain, and I absolutely adore the picture of him. Yeah, this was on my wantlist as well, but I never found a copy around there, and then this one was the first one I got at the record fair for 25 euros because the cover is pretty beaten, but I don't mind. I think it fits the mood of the record, and the record itself is in great shape, so I'm pretty happy about that. Pharoah Sanders with Leon Thomas, Shakuru, released on Teresa Records. I have to admit, I'm a absolutely huge fan of Pharoah Sanders, but his latest stuff is either hit or miss for me, and sadly this falls in the latter category for me. It's Pharoah Sanders, Leon Thomas, William Henderson, Ray Drummond and Idris Muhammad. What could go wrong? Yeah, well, the problem is, it's for me, it's bordering too much on the cheesy side, and I definitely prefer his spiritual, religious approach more. Gal Costa, self-titled album, originally released in 1969. This is the 1985 Brazilian repress. I picked this up at the Mr. Bongo stand, who has always the greatest selection of their own stuff and always a great selection of some Brazilian stuff. So it's always worth digging through it if you dig Brazilian music, because you always will find some gems. Mostly very pricey, but I found this for a really good price, and so I'm absolutely happy. And here we go, a decent early pressing of Jefferson Airplane's Surrealistic Pillow. And yeah, this is the kind of key album for me, and I'm really happy to finally have this in good shape. Another one that would have been on the want list was JK and Co. One Summer Suddenly One Summer on Wild Whale. I always mix up the titles, but maybe you know what I mean. I'll show a picture here so you can see what I mean. And we were talking with Ron Seller about it, and he was like, oh, I have that one at home, but I have a different Wild Whale record here, which was Zagan Evans and Others, The Early Writings. Which is kind of a compilation. The A side is Sega Nubbins and the B side is JK and Co. Which is pretty cool because there are some parts of the album there, so at least you can listen to it. Great shape, was still sealed. The A side, I think you know Sega Nubbins at least by their hit in the year 2525. This one's even more, not that edgy, but even more like pop. Which is okay, but I definitely prefer the B-side on this. In 2017, I showed the store of Francois, where I picked up the Free Slave Roy Brooks record, and he has just a great selection of jazz of any type. I was visiting him again and found the Art Ensemble of Chicago Phase 1, which was still missing in my collection. This is a repress, but I don't mind. July, self-titled album. This is the 1987 repress on Bam Caruso. I have a repress of this record at home, but I was delighted to find this because I also like the cover art and I prefer that here this way is on it in the alternate version, which is the version I prefer more, so pretty cool find. H.P. Lovecraft, where you could never go wrong with. And Life at Slux, Strawberry's record featuring Charles Tolliver, Cecil McBee, Stanley Cowell and Jimmy Hobbs. Which is absolutely great record and I'm really happy my husband picked it up. So, this were my finds. I hope you enjoyed it and the impressions of the record fair overall. Yeah, have you been there? Do you want to go there? Or would you say, oh no, it's just too much and too much records? Well, you never can have too much records, but like in an overwhelming sense where I think, okay, how should I ever cope this? Yeah, thank you for watching and I hope I will do another video this year. Time is just really tight. I will at least do a top 10 or top 20 records of the year thing. I'm pretty sure about that. And we are planning, like ages ago, we are planning to do kind of live set where we just play an hour of Brazilian music, an hour of Italian music or something like that and upload it to my channel. Would this be something you would be interested in? Let me know and see you soon. Bye!